50 kilometers off the Norwegian coast. For 3 days, the fishing vessel Susanna has been steering through rough seas. This is where Captain Manfred Rahr is fishing for pollock. The sonar can detect almost any form of life below the ship. His boat has a cold storage capacity for 100 tons of fish, but so far Captain Rahr has not had any luck.
Wir versuchen gerade krampfhaft ein paar Fische zu fangen, was uns aber im Moment nicht gelingt. Der Fisch hat ein anderes Verhalten, ein anderes Fluchtverhalten mittlerweile an den Tag gelegt und von daher müssen wir uns ein bisschen mehr anstrengen, den Fisch auch hinterher zu jagen und letztendlich auch zu fangen.
A couple of hours later, the men reel in the first net. The yield is rather small. There is only a little bycatch of undersized fish. This is due to the fact that the crew on the Susanna adheres to sustainable fishing practices. The mesh size of their nets is 25% larger than stipulated by the EU. But this is not common practice. Usually, all marine animals which get caught in the small mesh nets end up on the ship. Undersized, young, or otherwise undesirable fish are merely thrown back into the sea. This, however, is exactly the problem.
In der Nordsee zum Beispiel kann man rechnen, dass ungefähr ein Drittel, also ungefähr 30% des gefangenen Fisches und der Meeresfrüchte als Beifang wieder über Bord gehen. Das ist eine immens hohe Zahl. Wir reden hier von 500 bis 800 Millionen Tonnen, die jährlich ins Meer ungenutzt als Abfall entsorgt werden.
Everything that the consumer will not buy is just returned to the sea. On a global scale, the fishing industry wastes millions of tons of fish by doing so. This wastefulness has grown significantly. After all, this practice not only causes young fish to disappear from stocks, but also puts entire species in danger. Valuable seafood resources are lost forever.
Our main objective is that these fisheries can continue to exist in the future. We can still have fish to eat in 50 years' time, 100 years' time. And that this, therefore, the system has to be sustainable. It has to be a system that could be there forever. You know, all of the fishermen can live out of the fish, the people can eat fish, and the stocks can regenerate themselves to maintain this system.
So what can be done to protect marine life and seafood resources? The EU has taken action by introducing a new law to protect marine diversity, the so-called discard ban.
The basic idea is to avoid that fish is simply thrown back into the sea because it is not wanted or because the price for it is not good enough. We believe that in the end, if all the fish that is caught is also landed and used, we'll have a better system, we'll have a system in which the stocks will be healthier and therefore also the revenues will be better for those who do the fishing.
Until recently, fishing vessels went out to sea and caught all types of fish in their nets, including unwanted marine species, which were either too young or could not be sold. These discards were thrown back into the sea. The advantage for the captain is that by discarding the unwanted catch, he has more room for marketable fish. Even now, fishermen still throw parts of their catch back into the water. And these discarded fish rarely survive. The advantage for the fisherman is that in one tour, he only has fish on board that he can sell. But this practice is not allowed under the discard ban. Under the ban, fishing vessels are no longer allowed to throw unwanted fish back into the sea. Instead, they're obliged to land all caught fish in the harbor. Unsellable items are sent to fish oil or fish meal production plants, which produce raw materials for fish and dog food or for pharmaceuticals. The disadvantage for the fishermen, at least in the short term, likely less profit. But how can bycatch be reduced or even avoided? This is the question that scientists like Daniel Steputis pose. The biologist is currently looking for methods to limit the catch to exactly the type of fish which is desired.
Wenn es darum geht, Wege zu finden, um den unerwünschten Beifang zu reduzieren, dann gibt es einige Optionen. Die wichtigsten davon sind erstens die Frage, wann, wo und wo fischt der Fischer. Also er muss dann im Idealfall ein Meeresgebiet aussuchen, wo nur die Fische vorkommen, die er möchte. Und die nächste Frage, die er sich beantworten muss, ist, womit fischt er? Also welches Netz soll er, kann er benutzen, damit auch die Fische, die er nicht haben möchte, die dann trotzdem da rumschwimmen, entkommen können.
One important factor in the reduction of bycatch is the fishing net. Here, at one of the largest rope and fishing net producers in Europe, the scientists' ideas are tested and being put into practice. Currently, Daniel Staputis is working on the development of a net which will not only separate large fish from small, but will also do a lot more.
Wenn wir ein normales Schleppnetz haben, wir gucken jetzt hier gerade vorne rein, dann haben wir manchmal ja auch verschiedene Arten, die wir fangen, ja, von denen wir nicht alle behalten wollen. In der Ostsee zum Beispiel wollen wir ganz oft die Plattfische nicht mitfangen, weil einfach dafür kein Markt ist. Und da haben wir uns was überlegt, dass wir mit Gittern arbeiten. Die Gitter bauen wir so ein, dass die Plattfische da wirklich gut durchpassen, aber auch gezwungen werden, sich damit zu beschäftigen mit dem Gitter. Und vielleicht können wir noch irgendwas da vorne in den Weg bauen, dass die da einfach nicht durchtreiben können, wie so eine Art Verkehrsinsel.
Ja, dass sie wirklich ans Gitter geleitet werden auch.
Genau.
Scientists have found that flatfish are easily diverted by colorful plastic barriers. These barriers force the fish to swim to the left or right, where they can easily escape through a mesh system. This way, the catch would only consist of larger, roundly shaped codfish, which can be easily solved. These kinds of nets, which avoid or considerably reduce bycatch, are called smart gear.
Also so kann man sich ja ungefähr vorstellen, dass hier nachher die Fische durchschwimmen. Und wir müssen jetzt irgendwie dafür sorgen, dass die Flundern und die Schollen die Chance haben zu entkommen. Und dazu bauen wir hier dann Gitter ein und versuchen sie da in die Gitter zu treiben, dass sie merken, dass sie da entkommen können und das auch nutzen.
A few days later, the time has come to test a prototype of the new net in the Baltic Sea.
Wir haben Kameras im Netz und können mit den Kameras das Verhalten der Plattfische uns angucken und sehen, ob die genauso sich verhalten, wie wir uns das ausgedacht haben. Also die Erwartungshaltung ist immer groß. Der Aufwand, den wir treiben, ist ziemlich hoch. Und insofern wünschen wir uns natürlich sehr, dass es auch funktioniert am Ende.
Is it really possible to select which fish to catch? In the Baltic Sea region, flatfish is not very marketable. Since the nets are dragged along the ocean floor, the amount of flatfish caught as unwanted bycatch is generally very high.
Wir haben jetzt das Netz ausgesetzt, es ist unten am Meeresgrund, hier ist ziemlich flach, nur 15 Meter tief, und jetzt fischt das Netz erstmal vor sich hin.
At about 10 meters below the ocean's surface, the research ship pulls the new net along the floor of the Baltic Sea. The scientists have installed cameras at several crucial locations in order to later observe the behavior of the fish.
Was man total gut sehen kann, ist, dass hier an dem Hindernis die Fische nicht mehr einfach nur gerade hinterschwimmen, sondern rechts und links vorbei und in dieses Gitter rein. Ich bin begeistert. Die machen genau das, was sie sollen.
Hardly any flatfish are being caught in the rear part of the net. After 1 hour, one thing has been established. The scientists are on the right track.
Also ich glaube, wir haben heute einen großen Schritt gemacht, um der Fischerei ein Werkzeug an die Hand zu geben, mit dem sie in der Lage sind, auf das Anlandegebot zu reagieren, indem sie ihre Plattfischbeifänge optimieren, indem sie die unerwünschten Plattfischbeifänge reduzieren können und trotzdem ihre anderen Fänge behalten können.
Back in the Skagerrak. At his position on the 60th parallel, Captain Ra hopes for better luck. He fishes according to the Marine Stewardship Council fisheries standard. For the captain, this means that only marine animals of a particular size will be caught in his nets. Consumers can identify sustainable seafood based on the blue MSC eco label on the packaging. This evening, hardly any unwanted fish are caught in the net.
In der Seelachsfischerei hast du den geringsten Anteil an Beifang, sag ich mal so, weil das auch fast reine Seelachsfischerei ist, die wir betreiben. Du kannst nicht sehen, was wir machen. Das ist auch letztendlich ist es nicht nachzuvollziehen und letztendlich ist es auch nicht kontrollierbar.
Scientists in England are currently working on exactly such a monitoring method. They have developed a system which records the amount of bycatch on individual fishing boats and which also supervises whether the unwanted catch was illegally thrown back into the sea. Julian Roberts is a scientist at the Marine Management Organization in Plymouth. He uses a more radical approach for monitoring the EU's new discard ban.
The Marine Management Organization's role in preparation for the landing obligation has been to run trials using what we call remote electronic monitoring, using sensors on board the vessels and CCTV cameras, which allow us to ensure that certain species of fish aren't being discarded. Fishermen can take part in these trials on a voluntary basis and they receive extra quota in return for doing that.
The MMO has equipped about 50 ships with the new monitoring system. The cameras seamlessly record what the fishermen take on board and what subsequently happens to it.
Yeah, you can see here the fish goes into these two hoppers and then it goes up this conveyor. At the top of that conveyor is this position here, which is the sorting belt. The fish comes along here and at this end of the discard belt, the fish is discarded back into the sea.
The five cameras record everything. It's an enormous amount of data. Still, this enables the officers to monitor the activities on individual ships even several weeks later.
Broadly, the results have been extremely positive. We've reviewed the footage and the data from the systems to actually quantify the level of discards, which should be zero according to the regulation. But the results we've been getting is largely been less than 1%, which we think is sufficient and demonstrates compliance.
The total control system works and helps to change the fishermen's behavior. During the test phase, the discards amounted to less than 1% of the total catch. Even fisherman Dave Murphy decided to adopt the new method. Back in the harbor, fishermen like him receive a fixed rate of compensation for their bycatch. He appreciates the system, which helps the fish stock to recover.
I would have no trouble with cameras in the future. If all vessels had cameras, it wouldn't make any difference to me. I didn't find them intrusive because they're only on the deck, you know, where you're working. They're not as if they're not watching you sleep or eat or, you know, it's just purely there for the monitoring of the catch. And there was no real problem as far as I was concerned.
The onboard electronic monitoring system is probably the only method to efficiently enforce the discard ban. We're along with the Danish Coast Guard. One of the main tasks of Captain Jakob Andersen's crew is to monitor whether the fishermen adhere to their catch quotas and do not fish more than is allowed.
If it's on our risk list, it could be something like a misreporting of catch or failure to report a landing or a discrepancy between the amounts landed. So when these are registered, they pop up in our systems. So then we have to automatically look at them.
Andersen and his crew focus their attention on a small cutter. We are not allowed to bring our camera on board. In the future, the officers will also need to check whether boats like this are adhering to the new discard ban. Without the onboard electronic monitoring systems, it will be difficult for the officers to know how much fish is actually thrown overboard on an open sea.
Theoretically, a discard can occur even if you have a discard ban. So the only way to avoid that is to be on the vessel when it heaves up and note what his catch composition is and amounts, and make sure it is put in his logbook. That will be a challenge, I think, and I'm not quite sure how we're going to deal with that.
south of Norway, the Susanna is already heading back to her home port. The men have spent 6 days at sea. The storage tanks are almost completely filled with pollock. While the crew is cleaning and storing the fish in the lower deck, the catch data is saved on Captain Ra's hard drive and transmitted in real time via satellite to the Norwegian authorities.
Du musst bis um 24 Uhr musst du es abgegeben haben. Das kommt denn ja auch mal vor, dass wir um 8 Uhr heben wollen, festlaufen, 3 Stunden festsitzen und dann fängst du nicht an, hier im Computer was einzugeben. Dann musst du nämlich sehen, dass du dein Geschirr vernünftig hochkriegst. Dann musst du den Fang verarbeiten, wiegen und dann sollst du es abschicken. So, und wenn du dann noch ein Übertragungsproblem hast, was ja auch vorkommt, dann kommt das bei Norweger 2 Minuten nach 12 an. Und dann hast du zumindest die schriftliche Verwarnung erstmal weg.
The administrative effort to meet the requirements of the authorities is high, and the penalties for violations are as well. In the last 6 days, the Susanna still caught some non-target fish as bycatch in its nets, but not that many.
Ich glaube, wir haben insgesamt 32 Tonnen Fisch gefangen. Und das ist mein Discard, 30, 35 Kilo. Das wird morgen früh weggeholt, das geht hier in eine Gammelfabrik rein. Und dann haben wir da nichts mehr mit zu tun.
The fishermen receive a fixed price per kilo for their landed bycatch. Instead of ending up on the bottom of the ocean, the bycatch is sent to fish meal production plants. What remains is fish oil and fish meal, valuable raw materials for pharmaceuticals or animal feed. In addition, the amounts and species caught in the nets are recorded in order to improve the quality of the collected data on fish stocks. This information is very important to scientists so that they can make better predictions about whether fish stocks are healthy or overfished. The new EU discard ban regulation is one of the ways to help our oceans and fish stocks recover. In the beginning, the discard ban will probably make life harder for smaller fishing companies. Their expenses will rise and the competition will become increasingly fierce. It remains to be seen whether fishing will, in the long run, remain a profitable business for fishermen like Captain Dave Murphy.
I'm not destined to become a millionaire, but it would be nice to just carry on and earn a good living, and with the crew, you know, that's what we want. The only way that we'll be able to do this is to ensure that there is a fish stock in the future to catch, and also that we don't have to run in every 5 minutes because the boat's full of small fish, because that doesn't help anybody.
The future of fishermen will also be decided by consumers. Will they choose cheaper fish from inexpensive imports? Or will they choose sustainably fished products that could be more expensive?
Wenn ich die Fischerei der Zukunft mir anschaue oder mir überlege, wie das aussehen kann, dann hoffe ich zum einen, dass es noch eine Fischerei gibt. Und zum anderen hoffe ich, dass wir einige von den Problemen verbessert haben, die wir jetzt noch haben. Das heißt, wir haben weniger Beifänge, der Fischer hat Interesse daran und arbeitet aktiv daran, seine Fischerei besser zu machen. Und was ich auch hoffe, ist, dass der Verbraucher sagt, okay, wir honorieren, da ist nachhaltig gefangener Fisch. Es wird Auswirkungen geben auf die Umwelt, genauso wie Ackerbau auf die Umwelt eine Auswirkung hat. Aber die haben sich bemüht und die haben das Beste, was menschmöglich ist, gemacht, um das gut zu machen.
After one night at the harbor, the Susanna is heading out again. This time, the trip will take a little longer. Captain Ra's destination is the Faroe Islands. Be it the North Sea or the Atlantic, it's now up to the decision makers, scientists and the fishermen to sit down together and find the best solutions for reducing or eliminating bycatch in their regions. For all concerned, the objective is clear: to fish in a sustainable way.